And so, Sleeves, what do you do about armpit stains?
Not a problem.
Oh, here we go. I gotta tell you, one of the things I hear a lot out there is how funny we are.
No wonder they say that TV warps your mind.
What, I'm funny?
Really, says who?
They do.
The funniest monkey has to be Richard, him in his bedazzled pants. Hilarious.
The funniest monkey, I think, is Richard because he's always messing with the guys.
Whoa, man. Come on.
What? What's wrong? What, did we mess him up?
Hold on.
You got any scraps for me, Richard?
Damn, dude.
It's kind of cold by now, but I'd get to it if y'all was y'all.
The funny monkey is Richard. It's really fun to see him screaming and drinking beer.
Whoa!
It's a really fun guy.
Boo! Boo! Whoa! Boo!
The funniest monkey is Mike Coy. He's always joking around.
Sense of humor. On a scale of 1 to 10, about a 9. Keep it up, Mike.
Oh, come on now.
Mike Coy, always milking it.
What?
You know, one of the things I really enjoy here at Gas Monkey is having the fans come by just to say hi and then line up and see what cars we may have in the parking lot. But be sure to pay attention and don't miss any of the episodes because otherwise you might miss out on what happened to your favorite car, like this dude.
Do you have a question you've always wanted to ask?
Yeah, what happened to that Econoline pickup truck I was wanting to see when I got down here? He had one just sitting out that he never did nothing to it.
He built it.
He built it? Oh, okay.
Tom, come on, Tom. You're breaking my heart. I mean, I actually do still have that old Econoline. It just looks a little different than it did when it was sitting back in the lot. When the Mattel guys challenged us to build a car for their Redline Club, we went full Gas Monkey on them.
Chop.
Starting with the 63 Econoline I had sitting around, the idea was to build it into an exhibition drag car, a real throwback to the 60s. It wasn't enough that the motor was going to be sitting in backwards. No, we went for eye-popping overload. That meant some great big meaty rubber under the rear end.
The back tire just wows you. The width of that is amazing.
All the metalwork was pretty cool, but to make it grab your attention, I picked out a copper metal flake and told Coy to get after it. I think we go with that. Do you agree?
Yeah, I agree.
You agreeing just because I write the checks or because you like it?
Because you write the checks.
Paint job on that thing was really, really nice. Really cool looking car.
Even being a man down, the monkeys came together and hauled ass on the hypo hauler. Pretty well freaking the hell out. I'm just sitting in there in the office going, is it gonna get done? Is it gonna get done? Is it gonna get done? So I figured I'd just come back here and put some of that stress and strain on y'all.
Awesome.
Can you see it? Can you see it? You're gonna hear it before you see it. Fire that thing up!
And when we did the big reveal at Mattel, we had a new fan favorite and a ticket to enter the exclusive Hot Wheels Redline Club.
What do you think about that?
The hypo hauler you made for Hot Wheels. That thing is badass.
There we go, there we go.
That was one awesome build.
There you go, guys. The hypo hauler.
Richard, that hypo hauler episode was one of my favorites.
Gas Monkey is in the Red Line Club, guys. Yeah.
Holy cow. Now, that is definitely one of my favorite builds. I mean, what do you guys think? One of our other favorite things here, doing donuts. I think it's time for some donuts.
It's when you did the donut in the Monster Jam truck.
I really love the monster truck doing donuts, going around, going fast. That guy really is crazy.
Woo! Yeah!
It looks awesome when you're doing donuts, so we want to see more of them.
I said, hurry up!
Oh, God, oh, God, oh, God. The Viper drift car, all the smoke that was going around, it was just really cool.
You want to know what my favorite donut is? It's the episode that y'all had the supercharged Frankenstein truck and y'all did donuts in the parking lot.
From Ranch Cucamonga. I think it's awesome when the monkeys are always doing donuts with the forklift. So I'm just surprised none of them have been injured or anything.
I think John's gonna hurl. Let her rip, tater chip, little donuts. Woo!
Look at that, there's a cop right there.
Do a donut.
Richard, when you did donuts in that Trans Am, that was amazing.
You literally didn't see that. Oh, no, he did. That might have been a bad idea.
Good donut will get you every time.
The donuts on that Pantera reminded me of the ones on my Camaro. Get around going so fast.
Look at that.
Inertia just pulls you backwards, smoke from the tires.
Pretty good donuts, huh?
Kind of sugary. Man, I live for that stuff.
I wasn't talking about these donuts, man. What's wrong with you? Those donuts.
VW bus.
Golly.
That thing is ludicrous. How did you work that out?
Now, driving the shorty VW bus, that was kind of a job and an adventure. But if you remember, it left my hands at Barrett-Jackson Scottsdale.
A definite showstopper.
I took a little loss when a little lady by the name of Tammy Allen bought it for just 35 grand and added it to her collection.
I have a car museum in Grand Junction, Colorado, that I try to collect as really unique cars.
From Scottsdale, it made its way all the way to Colorado, but the museum it was in shut its doors. So guess where I found it?
In the trunk of an Escalade? It's that small.
No, silly. At Barrett-Jackson, Las Vegas, Tammy Allen was putting her whole collection up on the block.
I love this set. I freaking love it. I think it's so cool.
It is cool.
It's just great wheelies.
Can you imagine turning up to work in that?
Well, it's going to be pretty neat to see how much it brings the second time around. You know, did she get a good deal? Did I get a good deal? Did she, you know, does it go up? Does it go down? With the juice and shipping it around, she's 40 grand on the floor right here.
Here comes lot number 384, the 1966 Volkswagen Microbus. This VW 5, 10, 8, 10, 10.
When bidding on the VW didn't exactly take off, I smelled a bargain.
15, 20, Richard, you want in? Hey, 20.
So naturally, I bought it back.
So $30,000, thank you, Richard.
Hell, it's worth more than 30. I'll sell it again for a profit or just keep it. Why not? It doesn't take up much space. And here's some more shout outs from Fast and Loud fans all over the world. That's right, we got fans all around the world.
I'm Patch, this is Bryce. We're from New Zealand.
And we've come to check out the Gas Monkey Garage. What I love about the show is the cars, how they do the builds, just all the good banter. They're all yelling and screaming and just having a good time.
And the girls, we need the girls, we need a beer.
Hey there, Gas Monkey fans. My name's Heather Stenglein. I'm from Danville, Pennsylvania. It would be so easy to say that my monkey crush is Richard. I mean, come on, but that's as overdone as Richard's hair.
Holy cow!
I can't see where I'm going. I can't see where I'm going.
Oh. Woo!
Nope, I didn't make it.
Yeah, that's a good one. Is this how we waste our time?
Well, Richard's all right. I like he's crazier than hell.